So what do you get when you put Raspberry Pi 3 with Steam? You get awesome, that's what you get. Stick around to see what I mean. So the Raspberry Pi 3 was just released, and I really wanted to grip my hands on one of the first batches, just so I could have a play around with it and see how it felt and how it operated. And one of the things that I really wanted to try out was to use it as a streaming machine for my games. Now I know there's things out there like the Steam Link and Steam Boxes and so forth, but I didn't want to shell out that sort of money for something just to simply stream games to my HDMI TV. So with that said, I went out there onto the interwebs and I found out that there was a program out there called Moonlight. Now Moonlight is a program that can run on Linux and it allows you to stream games from a GeForce Experience capable video card. Now that's from the GTX 650s up. So if you've got one of the Nvidia cards, then you're in luck. So the first little hurdle that I came across was that I needed a 8 gig MicroSD instead of a 4 gig MicroSD. Now on my Raspberry Pi B Plus, all I needed was a 4 gig. So when I got to install it on the 4 gig and it didn't work and it said there was more space needed, I had to go back to the drawing board and get myself an 8 gig MicroSD card. But with that said, it wasn't too much of a hassle. So after copying the NOOBS software onto the microSD card and then installing the Raspberry and operating system, it was time to get into the actual Moonlight installation. So I changed a few config files and did a couple of sudo operations and bang, there it was. It was up and running. Now the first time I tried this, I did limit it to 30 frames per second and it worked beautifully. It didn't skip like I saw on the Raspberry Pi 2s that were released not that long ago, and it just worked. However, there was one issue. I hooked up a wired Xbox 360 controller to the Raspberry Pi 3, and for whatever reason, the mapping of the controller keys were all off. I should say controller buttons. So after a little bit more searching out there on the interwebs, I found there was a way of remapping the controller buttons for the Xbox 360 controller. And once that was done, everything just worked beautifully. So just to test it out, I threw Tomb Raider at it. Now initially, I've been playing it in 4K, so it was juddering really badly and I thought, this isn't right, that this is a Raspberry Pi 3. It's a quad core 1.2 gigahertz. So after having a little think to myself, I thought, maybe I should check the resolution. And lucky that I did because it was in 4K. So I swapped it back down to 1080p and bang, there was no stuttering, there were no jumping. It just worked. Now granted, I didn't try this on the wireless because my wireless is just hopeless. So there was no point in me even comparing it. It's hooked up to a gigabit Ethernet network at the moment, even though the port is 10100, and it still streams perfectly fine. Now, one of the things you'll have to look out for is that you do need to use one of the official Raspberry Pi power supplies. Now, I'm sure long after this video is released, there will be some third-party ones out there, but at this stage, I would highly recommend just sticking with the Raspberry Pi official power supplies. And lastly, you don't get a case with this thing either, so if you do want it to look aesthetically pleasing, you will need to purchase a case at the same time. So if you do want to try this out for yourself, I have left some links down in the description for where you can buy one for yourself. Well, that's it for another video. I really hope you liked it. If you did, leave me a comment down below or maybe even leave me a thumbs up. If you do enjoy the content that I'm providing, please make sure you subscribe to my channel because it really helps me a lot. And as always, imagine, learn, create. Bye. I was pressing X, but it's Y. Why is X Y?